let's talk about some of the reasons you may choose a Mac. Now, first up, Macs are the best at multimedia. If you're doing any kind of video editing, if you're doing hardcore photo editing, really Macs tend to be the place where it is preferable for most artists to work. Now, I know that most creative applications are also available on Windows. If you want to run Photoshop, there's a Windows version. If you want to run audio apps, there's usually a Windows version as well. Although Macs are known for their stability in the operating system. And so if you're a DJ live on set and you want to run some kind of live production software keyed into a mixing desk, then you're probably going to find yourself working with a Mac over Windows. The next thing that's great about Macs is the interoperability between different devices. Basically, your work automatically synchronizes, and through the Apple ecosystem and iCloud, you've got one great experience of everything basically being in the same place. And not only that, but just in general, the ecosystem of devices means that everything plays really nicely together. And so you'll have things like, if you've got a call on your phone, you can switch that call to your desktop computer, or you can answer the call on your desktop computer. If you've got something that you've cut and pasted on your iPad, you can flick that from your computer to your phone and back again. If you make a note on your phone, it's going to appear on your other devices. And basically, when a call comes in, all of your devices will ring simultaneously. And that's really the beauty about Mac, is you've got that one fluid ecosystem. If you've got a set of AirPods, you can go between your phone and your computer seamlessly, and everything just works. You don't have to mess around with different Bluetooth devices, trying to link or relink them. It just all works in one hit. And so that's probably the best reason that Macs are a popular choice. Though there's one big downside to working with Macs, and that is their price. This is literally a gold, Apple don't sell this, this is in here as a joke. This is literally a gold-plated MacBook Air, which I think is $15,000 or $20,000. But Macs come with a price tag. And I mentioned earlier that I had a Mac that I spent over $4,000 Australian dollars on that I returned for a Chromebook because I was more than happy to get my work done in Chrome. So let's talk about Chrome and some of the advantages of working with ChromeOS other than the other operating systems if you're choosing a new machine. First up, we have the ability for Chrome to do most of its heavy lifting on the web. And what that means is you get a faster machine because it's not doing all of the crunching on the local computer. And that has a number of advantages. Number one, if you're using Google Documents, all your work is automatically saved and backed up. So you never have the issue of getting 2 hours into a document, having your computer crash, and then corrupting or losing the file. You don't have to mess around with things like you would need to on a Windows or a Mac computer, like Dropbox, like working on a file, saving it in Dropbox, and waiting for it to synchronize to someone else. When you're working on a Google Doc or any of the Google suite of applications in the web, everything is instantly saved and works immediately. Because of that advantage, you have much better performance on all Chrome devices. They just work much better. It means they're stable and it means they're fast. Because basically, you're not having to worry about all of the local machine using its heavy resources. Google's supercomputers are doing all of the work in the background. And what does that result in? Well, much better battery life. All day battery life and seriously, seriously impressive battery life from machines that are quite affordable. So finally, security and the protection of viruses, protection of malware, these are the kind of things that right now don't really exist on Chrome OS. They will, over time, start to become more of a challenge. And as more people use Chrome OS, you can see it's outselling Macs now, so it's more of a target. There will be more opportunities for, you know, hackers and people who are trying to steal your information to build applications that may find their way into Chrome OS. Although most of the security breaches that happen around Chrome OS are just really tricking you to do things on the web. And that's something that the operating system itself can't control. Each Chromebook has a secure hardware chip, and that secure hardware chip stops any malicious code from running on the device. And they're basically completely locked down to the Google ecosystem. And on a Chromebook, because you don't have access to the back end of the operating system, you pretty much only get a Chrome browser and a file browser and whatever other apps that you install on there. It's a very, very secure way of working with your device. Now, finally, one of the best advantages of working with Chrome is that they are manageable for a company. And so if you're a business using Google Workspace, you can use the admin panel to set up literally one of hundreds of different policies for all of your Chrome devices, and they just get delivered via the web. So you don't have to worry about things like servers or installing Active Directory or anything like that. Basically, your policies get set up inside your Google account, and then they get automatically pushed down live via the cloud to all of your Chrome devices, which means management is an absolute breeze. If you're a business owner and you've not yet been taken through our growth roadmap, then you may be interested in a free consultation with our team. If you qualify, our team will take you through the growth roadmap and see where the gaps are, if there's anywhere where you might need help on your business journey with your technology strategy. Now, if you are an existing Google Workspace user for your business, we have an amazing transfer in offer where you basically get access to a Google Classroom with professional training for you and your team to use Google Classroom to the best of its ability. We envisage this to be part of your HR onboarding process. So when you hire a new employee, you put them in the classroom and they go and receive a certificate once they've completed the class and the quizzes, so you know they know how to use Google Workspace. And so in here, each lesson has module by module, an easy way for everyone to get through the different stages of learning all about Workspace. And that makes you sure that your team have all of the skills and all of the competency required to be productive in your business. Now, to get access to the transfer in offer, not only do you get access to the classroom, you get free limited access to our support team. You get a free check of your DNS records just to make sure that you've set up all of the records correctly in your Workspace account. Sometimes people miss the SPF or DKIM or DMARC records and emails can end up in spam and that kind of thing. So we just do a little check there. And then finally, if there's ever an issue there, then you actually have emergency access from our team. We have backup access to your account. If you're interested in that offer, head along itgenius.com/transfer and get access to that. Thanks for being here, guys, and we will catch you in the next one. If you have questions, drop them below, and we will see you soon. Cheers.